I'm bipolar, bisexual, bicoastal, bilingual, bipedal, the word, and, thank God, biodegradable. I disappeared at birth. If Alice never lived in Wonderland, Amy never lived here at all. Why would I leave bones behind? He thinks he feels the same. I see his ashes burn the air, the wind dripping like wax. That's if anyone cares enough to blow out his candle. I don't. And he won't blow out mine. I know his name but won't grant him passage in my dictionary. Once in, he'll redefine me and close the book. He's a cockroach. That's my nickname for him. But a cockroach doesn't ask to be one. He's nothing more than a pronoun and a bangarang to me. I can't stand pretending anymore. It's time I call him with the truth. All I want to do is fuck, I tell him, meaning it, Mina. Get it? That's all you ever mean to me. Alright, he says. He actually means it. 10 minutes later, he arrives. In. Out. Soon but not soon enough, he's gone again. Pass. My phone notifies me I have a text message. I've no friends, including him, so it must be him. Is there any reason as to why you do anything? Is there any reason, he says, as to why you do absolutely anything? He emails 24 more amphetamine-based appraisals. I don't have to read between the lines to see the subtext he all but underlines. He blames me for his faults. Like amputated ghost limbs, my fingers type what I most and least want him to know. I draw my own fault lines. I can't erase yours. I also can't let you go. But why? I ask myself. I can do better. No, I can't.
No, I can't.
No, I can't.
No, I can't. Trust him. That's why I'm killing him. On purpose. Underneath his surface. Each day, he takes more pills than he should. Because, he says, I'm driving him crazy. But I'm only driving him. I hope he dies of cancer. He's the smoker. I'm the carcinogen. It's not my fault. I may drink too much, but I'm not a drug addict. Besides, if I'm two of a kind of everything, he's singular at most if not all of what little he is. He believes in something. God. He won't say it, but I will. I don't believe in me. Infinity frightens me right back into the corner where I always need him again. He knows it. God tells him so. That's when I get the feeling he gets what I'm feeling. That's when I start reeling him in again. That's when I get the feeling he gets what I'm feeling. That's when I start reeling him in again. He knows because he read my diary. And then he stole it. I've looked everywhere. I call him, bring my diary back or I'll call the police. A minute later, I phone him again. Never mind. I found it. I realize I've forgotten to read what my fingers wrote. The automatic writing triggers automatic second thoughts. I backspace to first instinct. I will kill you. I don't type his sentence. He doesn't deserve to see it coming. I've always known I'm Mother Earth. I never wanted children. I didn't make him. I wouldn't make that mistake. Nobody understands how much I love all living beings. Except human beings. Especially him. I call him one last time. Come over here, I order, a chair in one hand, razor in the other. As soon as he arrives, I look at him and say, sit here, please, as I set the chair beneath him. You need a haircut. I think of his next birthday party, which no one will attend. He'll kill himself. Why should I do it for him? Just go. I tell him out of nowhere. I hate his face when it turns into a question mark. He thinks I have the answers. He thinks I suffer less. He wants me to console him. Mother Earth can't console herself, let alone cockroaches. I take the razor from my pocket. 2 weeks later, I'm still wearing long sleeves.